Yes, the book talks a lot about asking, praying, asking, and it also talks about meditation, which is listening. And so, yes, we're supposed to ask God for direction and then listen through, usually God talks to you in a small, still voice within. Sometimes he talks to you through others. Sometimes he talks to you through the book. Sometimes he talks to you through songs. There's a lot of ways that God talks to you, but you have to keep keep your ears open to listen. And then another step to the equation is doing what he says, obeying, doing God's will, doing what he tells you to do. So, you know, it's really important. And that's what's so great about these particular steps is they're steps of action. It's not just steps of theory or feeling good or like, oh, I believe. Like I used to, I was a born-again Christian way before I was sober. And I used to always think that that was enough. Like, oh, I'm forgiven. Like, I hurt you. Oh, too bad, I'm forgiven. And I couldn't stay sober because that was my distorted thinking. And what the big book tells me is if I want to stay sober, I have to make amends to the people I hurt. So I hurt you, I stole $1,000. I can't say, oh God, forgive me, I stole $1,000. I got to give you $1,000 if I stole $1,000 from you. I have to make amends. I have to restore right relationships through the action of these steps. So this book is not a book of dogma. It's not just knowing God, but it's doing what God says. And that was my distortion before when I was just religious. Now, I still believe in the same God, and I still believe that the same God gave me the power. So it's not that my beliefs are any different. It's just that the way that I approach God is in a different fashion today. Because I used to go to God, and I used to like tell him what I was going to do because I would claim things. And it all fell apart. I had 14 years of sobriety. When I first came in the program, I got 14 years of sobriety, and my dad got sick. And my father was the light of my life. And, you know, I had thought, I'm 14 years is a long time. I'm never going to drink again. There's no way I'm going to drink again. And my father was sick, and I kept going to the hospital and kept claiming healing on him, like, you're going to get healed. Like, and he was dying. And I just kept finding verses from the big book and just saying, you're going to get well, you're going to get well. And, you know, and he was dying. And so then when he died, I just felt so disconnected from God that I just drank again. But it wasn't God's fault, it was my fault. So then when I came back to the program, I realized that the way to pray is not telling God what to do, especially using his own words against him, telling him what to do, but that I would pray, thy will be done. And not that his will be done, because his will is going to be done whether I pray it or not, but that I can align my spirit into his will. And that's why I pray thy will be done, so that I can accept the things that are going to happen because God's going to be God. And then I can be a constructive part of that process. If I would have been less demanding at that part, I might have had my mind open and been more helpful to my father in his last days rather than trying to buck the system here. So I just wanted to say that from in my own experience that it wasn't until I started doing these books that I could truly connect with that God that I knew through dogma and through teaching. But through the practical application of these steps, I couldn't truly connect with that God. So, anyway. All right. With all Ernest, back on page 58.
Yeah.
As we digress.
Yeah.
We thought we could find an easier, softer way. Some of us have tried to hold on to our old ideas, and the result was nil till we let go absolutely. Remember that we deal with alcohol, cutting back, lean, powerful. Without help, it is too much for us, but there is one who has all power. That one is God. May you find him now. We've read all of that already. Half measures availed us nothing. We stood at the turning point. We asked, and in the original manuscript, it said, throw yourself under his protection and care with complete abandon. Now, and what are we abandoning? Self. We're abandoning self. Trying to control self. That's what we're abandoning. Here are the steps we took, which are suggested as a program of recovery. So many people want to misinterpret what that word suggested means there, that they think that they could take them or leave them, that they could do the steps their own way. Oh, well, I'll do this program smorgasbord style. I'll take what I want and leave the rest. That's not what suggested means. Think of that suggested, if you want to get sober, more like if you're jumping out of an airplane, they suggest that you pull the cord on the parachute. It's like, you know, that's a suggestion. You know, if you want to live, if you don't want to splat in 2 seconds, then perhaps you should. It's the same thing here. It's a suggestion, but you will not have happiness or sobriety. You will not stay sober, or you will not live a successful life if you don't do the steps. So it's the same kind of a must. So please don't misinterpret that word suggested.